Hi, Robbins. I'm here with my friend, Hank, the horse. Say hi, Robbins. Hank says hi, too. Yes, of course. I'm going to read you one of Hank's favorite books. It's called Barnyard Hullabaloo. And there's a lot of rhyming in this book. So feel free to join in, Robbins, okay? It's called Cock-a-Doodle-Doo, Barnyard Hullabaloo. Early in the morning, as the sun began to rise, the pigs are feeling hungry as they're snorting in their sties. The rooster wakes the farm up with a cock-a-doodle-doo. The sheepdog won't stop barking, and the cows begin to moo. There's stomping in the stables, and there's a bleating in the barn. So let's climb aboard the tractor and explore this noisy farm. Lots of things going on in this farm. Rooster. Cock-a-doodle-doo, cock-a-doodle-doo, I'm the rockin' rooster baby. Tell me, who are you? Chickens. We chickens are covered with feathers all over our wings and our legs. So of course we could fly if we wanted to try, but we're too busy laying these eggs. Chickens are doing a lot of laying eggs. And there's baby chicks down there. Cow, sometimes I moo while I'm chewing. I hope you don't think it's rude, but mooing and chewing are what I like doing. Do you moo when you chew your food? That would be silly, wouldn't it, Robbins? Here's the sheepdog. I am the farmer's old sheepdog, his faithful and loyal best friend. I've been by his side from the day I was born, and I'll stay with him right to the end. Barnyard cat. Hello, I'm the big barnyard kitty. I sleep in the shade of the house, but I always keep one eye half open to spot every passing little mouse. There's a little mouse trying to get by the cat. Here's the pigs. I love taking care of my piglets and watching them wriggle and squeal. They clamor all over each other all day to snuffle around for a meal. Wiggle, 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 wiggle. They look like happy little piglets, don't they? Donkey. It's wonderful being a donkey. I simply spend hours and hours just wandering around on the soft grassy ground, sniffing the sweet-smelling flowers. Uh-oh, here comes Gobble, turkey, turkey. I've got these funny floppy things that hang down from my neck. They dangle when I gobble, and they wobble when I peck. There those turkeys. Cackle, cackle, cackle. Geese. We waddle about in the barnyard, and we make so much noise when we talk that wandering goslings rush out of our way as we babble and cackle and squawk. The baby goslings don't like all the noise. Sheep. I've got gorgeous fluffy fleece, which makes me very proud. So I skip around my meadow, make believing I'm a cloud. I sometimes hang out by the sheep pen, chuckling into my beard. Sheep often think that they're better than us, but goats never need to be sheared.
That's true.
Uh-oh, this is Hank's favorite page. Hank, here comes the horse. Horse. There's nothing like hay when you're hungry. I'm happy to munch a whole bale, but sometimes I stop for a clippity-clop or to flick a few fleas with my tail.
There he is. There's his tail.
Bull. How does he look? A little angry. I love to snort steam from my nostrils. It makes me look angry and tough. And then I start scraping my hoof on the ground, if that isn't scary enough.
He does look scary to me. I wouldn't want to encounter him.
Fox. Uh-oh, it's nighttime. Here come the nocturnals. I wait in the woods until nightfall, then down to the barnyard I creep, because nothing looks quite as delicious as chickens who've fallen asleep. Owl. I always hunt at nighttime, and I sleep throughout the day. Tr-wit, tr-woo, you'll hear me cry, out searching for my prey.
Yep, those owls are nocturnal.
Now it's nighttime in the barnyard, and the moon is shining bright. It's time to leave the animals and wave them all goodnight. The cows are feeling sleepy, so they settle on the ground. It won't be long now till they're sleeping safe and sound. The horse is in his stable and the hens are in their shed, but the sheepdog's fallen fast asleep inside the farmer's bed.
The end.
Did you like that book? I like that book too. Robins, I thought we would do a little bit of horse art with Hank. Are you ready? It's pretty easy. All you need is some construction paper. I have orange. I kind of wanted a brown horse to match Hank, but I didn't have any brown paper, so I'm using orange. And all I've done on my paper is I've drawn two triangles, I've drawn kind of an egg shape, and I've drawn a straight line. And so now I'm going to cut those shapes out. I'm going to cut along the line. And then I'm going to cut out the egg shape. Doesn't have to be perfect. And then I'm going to cut out these little triangles. Here comes another triangle. Okay, there we go. So, now what I'm going to do is I've got my glue, and I'm going to glue down. This, believe it or not, is going to be the horse's neck. There it goes. And I'm going to put some glue on the egg shape. And this is going to be the horse's head. Now, of course, my horse needs a few ears, so I'm going to put one. I'm going to put the two triangles on the top. There's one triangle, and here's another triangle. Oops, I did the wrong side there. Wait a minute. There we go. There we go. I'm going to give my horse some eyes. There's some eyes for him and a nose. Then you can either cut a strip of paper like this. Just make a long line. Do some good cutting. And then do a little bit. Not cutting all the way to the bottom, like this. And I'm going to cut it, and that's going to be the hair for the top of his head. I'm going to squish it around a little bit. There's some hair for the top of his head. And then you can do some hair for down his back. You can do this again, like I'm doing. This is the mane of the horse. The little horse, the hair that's going down his back. Now, if you don't have enough construction paper, you could just draw the hair on. I'm going to do a little scrunching up of it so it's not perfect. And then I'm going to glue it down. So my horse has a mane. And there's my horse. Well, Robins, Hank and I hope you had fun.
I hope you maybe do a little horse art. And we'll see you next time. Bye, Robins.